Dueling Excel podcast, episode 54, an approximate multiple lookup. Oh, this is a crazy one. He has some lookup values here, car, truck, Jeep, and he wants to look through column A and find all of the cells that contain the word car. I have two solutions to this. Both of them are macros. The loop macro, I have my cell selected there. Press the loop macro. Bam, there's the answer. Cool, huh? And then the filter macro. I actually see the screen flash a little bit there, but you get the same answer. Right, let's take a look at those two macros. Alt F11, I already have those written. The first one, the loop macro, fairly basic macro. If you take any course in Excel, VBA macros, you're going to get to these loops. Figure out how many rows we have today for each cell in the selection. We look for that cell. That's the variable, look for. And we're going to go from row 2 down to the last row, in this case 2 to 10. Over in column A, we're going to use the InString function. Now, this is a VBA function. It's not an Excel function. InString looks for a certain value in another string. If that's greater than 0, that means that it's found. And once it's found, we go to our current cell, offset 0 rows, 1 column over, and write the value. And then this counter is a variable. I increment that by 1 for anyone who is new to macros. But I like this one. Do filter unselected. Let's run this one step at a time. And you'll see how it's going. So for each cell over there in column C in our selection, I built a variable called lookFor, and that lookFor is what we're looking for, car, with an equal sign, an asterisk before it, and then another asterisk afterwards. So it builds actually a little criteria there. And then I'm going to do this AutoFilter. The AutoFilter says, hey, we're going to look through the first column, that's column A. The criteria is, in this case, is car, so I run that line of code. Let's go look at the Excel spreadsheet. Look at that, it gave me all of the car entries. All right, then we do a special cells, visible cells only, copy those, and look, I was smart enough here to start in A2, that way I don't get the word list. I also always get a blank beneath the auto filter, that way even if nothing's found, I still end up with one cell. So we've copied that, and then I'm going to do a paste special transpose. Press F8, you'll see how that's done. All right, so now does it matter which one you do? Well, in this small case, it really does not matter because there's hardly any items to look up, but it's going to start to matter when you have lots of items. So here I have 100,000 items over in column A that it has to look through. All right, so it's going to start to make a difference. Let's do a little time test here. So we're going to run the loop macro. You can see the things actually slowly appear. Took about 7 seconds to go through and do all that. Now let's compare it to the filter macro. About 4 seconds to go through and do the filter. So you start to get a little bit of a difference there depending on how many rows of data you have over there in column A. All right, so that's my solution. That's VBA. Mike, let's see what you have.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Wow, gotta love that VBA. That loop is awesome. And that filter, I have a question for you, Mr. Excel. Was that a recorded macro where you actually turned the macro on, did the filter, and then turned the macro off? If that was the case, that'd be pretty cool. I might even be able to do that then because I don't know how to write VBA. That's why I'm stuck with formula. Hey, so this is an approximate match, approximate lookup where we're looking for car. That's not an exact matchup. It's got the word car there, but it doesn't exactly match that cell. And we're returning multiple items, so I need these two items to be listed across the columns here. So first I'm going to count, and I'm going to use the search function. Search is great. We can say, hey, find car, and usually you say, find it there, and it tells you the 8th position character is where car starts. But we're going to give it the whole range of values there, and I'm going to hit the F4 key, and what it does now is it'll give us 8 here and 6 here, because that starts at the 6th character. All the other ones will give us an error. So if we highlight this, it's an array, right? This argument is expecting a single value, but we give it a range of values. So when we hit F9, it gives us an array of numbers when it finds cars and value error when it does not. We can simply wrap isNumber around that, and that'll give us a true whenever it sees a number. And to convert those numbers, trues and falses, to numbers, we'll use double negative because we need to count, right? So F9 gives us a 1, 1. We'll put sum product around that. And that'll count those. And sum product can handle this array. So we just hit Enter. Now I'm going to double click and send this down, and we can see we get our count. So for example, there are no cows here. Now I'm actually going to copy this is number search, because we'll have to use that in our formula over here. Now, we need to return multiple items. And when we get to the here, we only have two. When we get over here, we need a blank. So we're going to have to start this off with an if. And we're going to say we're in E2. So I'm going to say columns. And columns could be used as a number incrementer. So we say E2 colon E2. Right now, we say from column E to E, how many columns are there? One. But one, because this is locked and this is not, we'll get 2, 3, et cetera, as we copy over across the columns. And we're going to say anytime that number is greater than this, and F4 lock the column. Anytime that's the case, we need a value of true, double quote for blank, comma, and the value of false will be our lookup function, index. Now, index, we need to tell it what we're looking up. We're looking up these whole values, and then the F4 key to lock it. And then comma, and the only tricky part here is the row number. Because look at this. We have row 1 and row 3 for car, right? So we actually need to extract row numbers as we copy across the columns. Now, I'm in 2010, so I'm going to show you a 2010 solution. And then I'll show you the 2007, 2003 solution down here. I'm going to use the aggregate function. The aggregate is great. We ultimately need to use the small function to extract row numbers as we go to the side. But aggregate can, the first argument is function, and it has the small function as one of its options. So I click that, and it puts in a 15, comma. And just a moment ago, we saw that the array from search returns value errors. And so we don't want those to mess up our formula. So aggregate has ignore errors as the options. And there's lots of different ones, but we want 6, comma. And here's our array. We need to create an array of all the row numbers and then extract just the ones we want. I'm going to, in parentheses, type row. Now, if I highlight this and hit the F4 key, that'll give me 2, 3, 4, et cetera, as an array. But 2 is not really one, because Toyota car is the first item in the list. So from this row, I type minus row. I click in that first cell. Now, right now, it'll give us 2 minus 2, which is 0. So we add 1 back in. That little array, close parentheses, will give us all the row numbers. But we don't want all of them. We want just, for car, 1 and 3. So I'm going to divide this by and Control V. That's that is number search. That's already got the trues and falses for where car is located in this column. So I'm going to hit the F4 key on this, because we need to lock that one going to the side also. Remember, car, but when we go down, we need to move to truck. Now let's just see what this does right here, or F9. Look at that, 1 and 3. Those are the two row numbers for our car. The divide by zeros will be eliminated by that 6. Control Z. All right, array. Finally, we need our K, which says which item do we want. Do we want the first, second, the second smallest, the third smallest? So we use our same number incrementer from over here. And that argument right there, I Control V. I close parentheses on the aggregate. And the beauty of the aggregate is it's not going to require Control-Shift-Enter, because that argument can handle an array. All right, index, we already have the row number. The aggregate's going to deliver it. And if I highlight this and hit the F9, it better be row 1. Sure enough, it is. Close parentheses on the index, close parentheses, because the index is the value of false. And Enter. No Control-Shift-Enter, even though there's a bunch of array stuff in there. And then I'm going to copy it down. So sure enough, it works. Now, the only difference in earlier versions is when you get to the index right here, row number, you got to use the actual small. And if you download this workbook, you can see that right there, or hit pause for 2007 and earlier. Otherwise, this great new aggregate function right here. All right.
I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel.